again, it's nearly 6:30, we're in the Europa shopping mall. Today's been more than interesting, but first I'll talk about the paintings which I've produced today. Now, if we look at this area, I've put a parrot in, but I've also put butterflies, and I really believe that this particular area is very beautiful, what I've done. Beauty has got to be attached to this, because that is what I've always painted. Anyone who looks at my paintings will know there's beauty attached to them. And this particular scene is important, because many people have asked today, what is the same image going up and up? And I've tried to explain, it's the spirit that leaves the body when we pass over. And this is the transition. A transition that brings beauty and warmth and love. And when we get further up, we see the little lad who's a little bit older, and again, they've got this very spiritual feeling around. Now, I have spent time trying to create the sky. I'm still not happy with this sky that I originally done. Maybe tomorrow I'll sort it out, but I'm not happy with it. But today has been more than productive. Not only did we have people first thing in the morning that were showing real interest, there was a lady artist who came with a family. And so to get an opinion off a fellow artist, and probably an appreciation as well, it was interesting. And the daughter, who could speak fluent English, conducted the conversation for quite a while. But anyway, this morning we had a situation where a gentleman from the press arrived. He'd already rung the management of Europa to see if he could do an interview with the purpose of putting some of the story in the paper of what this painting's about and why in Banska Bystrica. So, along with, I can say now, our good friend Michael, who's part of the management team of this big shopping mall, he conducted a translation. And I put forward some of my views and the essence of what the picture is about. Now that, with a little bit of luck, will go into circulation maybe Friday or Saturday. And apparently this particular paper is supposedly the main or the biggest paper with the biggest circulation. So whatever the paper is and wherever the story reaches, it's all part of this journey. Now this is quite remarkable in many respects, because today marks the seventh day that I've been painting in the store. And really, as I've said previously, the amount of interest, and now we've got a situation where it will go into the Slovakian newspaper, but there's also talk of doing a radio show where questions can be put to me from the shopping mall. I believe this is only just the beginning, but still it's a very good beginning, and it gives one a lot of encouragement to where we are at. And again, I want to stress this journey that is going down this river in a route we don't know precisely where, but there's to others that are more than doing their share in the canoe of paddling. I've mentioned it before, but I have to say it again, because there's so many important parts which I have to say that Craig and Pecho are playing in this. It's all part of, I believe, a bigger picture which is beginning to emerge. So really, on that sort of note, and we're looking at this situation, which I think, and this is me and this is not one just admiring my work, but I do know when something is looking truly beautiful, and this is part of the picture. But again, as I was explaining to different people today who wanted to know more, there is a bigger picture. And the bigger picture is that this picture will make its way to Palestine and Israel. But it's going to have a wider audience than that. And I know for a fact, as I've said before, with the conversation that went today, many schools will be paying visits when more images are created. I was asked today how many children's images would be in this picture. Well, there's well over 100 now, and it's my thinking that before the picture's finished, there may be at least 300 images of children. So really, the essence of this picture, which is called Children Are Our Future, has quite a wide span for its audience. And that's very gratifying, because we made this challenge and we've come down this metaphorical river, and we don't know where it's taking us to, but we're quite confident that the route that's been chosen is the right route, and it will lead to where this is meant to go. So with those words, on Wednesday evening at 6:30 in Banska Bystrytska, I'm going to say good night, and again thank you to all those that are following this journey. So again, good night and thank you. Well, we're here again in the shop in Mal. It's 6:30 Slovakian time. It's been a very good day again. I'm saying that because, again, this has been some very interesting people that have been with us. Only an hour ago, we had two young girls that are from one of the universities who could speak fluent English, just come back from New York, and they're going to talk about inviting us to their university to do a talk. So already, within this week of being here, the different contacts we're making and the people that are approaching us are quite incredible. Well, today saw me concentrating on this area where these doves now are surrounding this scene. I've still got to put a few flicks in the hair of the little boy and the girl. But again, if we look up above to the sky scene, I've spent quite a bit of time this morning tidying up and trying to make the sky something like I want to see it. And again, over here, around this situation with the angels, I've spent quite a bit of time again, which is beginning to make it look quite something. So again, that took me up till lunchtime, and I'm pretty satisfied with what I've got. This afternoon, we come to this little boy. Now, there's a little bit of a story with it, because only yesterday I was really in a quandary what to do next on the painting. And I was thinking of this lad here that is in this terrible injury situation. And I thought, well, if I put him in transition, what would I like to see him with? Well, what I was thinking of was a teddy bear. Well, what's unusual about that? Well, I'd been struggling to picture the sort of teddy bear I would want to illustrate. But later, last evening, Craig came to me again with some images, and he didn't know what I was thinking. But what did he do? He brought me this image of a little boy with a teddy bear. And this is what I believe is, again, synchronicity. What I was thinking was provided, and here we have this little lad, which again is in transition from this body. Tomorrow I'm going to put children around him, but no wings, just children. And I will do him again in another sequence up here, and hopefully we can see this area coming together. And so gradually this picture's taking shape, but the more it takes shape, the more interest we're getting out of this shopping mall. I can't say enough of some of the people who've actually approached us and talked about various things and where it's going. So with those few thoughts, I'm going to finish this evening by saying again that we're definitely on track. This picture has definitely got legs. Many people are saying, where's it going to go to next? I'm saying it's going to go to Palestine and Israel. And whereabouts in Palestine and Israel is it going to go to? Well, it's my belief it'll go to universities. And there, when the pitch is finished, I will be able to give talks on what it represents and the way to get peace. This is the journey that this picture, I hope and believe, will make. So again, we finish on a high note, a positive note, and I'm looking forward for tomorrow. And so with those words, I'm going to say good evening and thank you again. Well, we're Friday night, it's 6:30. Yes, I'm feeling a little bit tired, but again, it's been a good day. Today I've painted this young girl, and she's from Brazil. Now, as I've said, the picture will fill up with children from around the world. It's as though this is the first one to emerge. But I've put her next to this young baby, because the more I've thought about it, we've seen the situation here of what conflict and war can bring to children. And when this happens and they lose their life, it's my belief that the spirit rises. And we're seeing here this beautiful little boy. A little boy that would have had life, but conflict and war destroyed him. But his spirit moves on. Now, I thought it was a little bit poignant last night when I put the bandages of which he was carrying from this terrible disaster, if we call it that. So it was rather poignant. Now, some people may think that's getting a little bit too far side of the Harry, but it's a reality. But what's happened? We've seen now a rabbit in the spirit world that's greeting him, and that takes away the harshness of what death brings, because it's my belief that when we pass over children as well, they go into a world that is full of love, colour, animals and all the loved ones. So what I'm doing here with the rabbit and everything else is converting this little lad's life, which is now into spirit, and again the next image will come there. So again, I just think it's taken away the harshness of what I'm showing. Now again, it's been a day where so many people keep coming up and using the word beautiful, but really there's going to be a lot of harrowing images, especially from Africa with the starvation and everything else, which is going to be conveyed. But it would appear that I'm putting it in a situation that takes away the harsh reality, although it's still there and it's a symbol of what's happening, a reality. And I just feel that the birds, the animals and everything else is taking that severe note away. Now, there was a quirky moment today. As I say, there's been a lot of interest today. There's probably been more people that have actually stopped and tried to make conversation than any day since we've gone to here. Now, there was one young couple that came, and the girl was looking at the picture for quite a while. And then I heard her say one or two words in pretty good English. And when I looked down and she started to talk, I said, "Are you from America?" And she said, "No." But anyway, a conversation carried on. She was really interested, but something was drawing me towards her. And I said to her, I says, you're a very special person. And she says, "How do you mean?" She says, "Well," I says to her, I says, "I've got a feeling that you're going to go to the Middle East." She seemed in shock when I told her that, because she said she'd lived so many years in Riyadh, which is Saudi Arabia. So that was a little bit of clairvoyance on my part. But I was so taken by the young woman and her interest, and her English was very, very fluent. And so I said, "I'm going to give you a drawing of one of the images that I've done. And when the picture's complete, I will invite you and your boyfriend to a meal to celebrate the situation it is." Now, when she went, if one is to believe what I say, I was told by spirit that that girl will accompany us to the Middle East. She's got the contact here with myself and what we're doing, but I was told that in the near future she will make herself known when this picture's complete, And it's my belief, as I've said before, with the picture going to the Middle East, that she will be part of this. And the reason being is she's lived out there amongst the situations which I'm going to be visiting, and so I believe that to be the case. So again, I'm quite happy with how the day's gone. There's been people here from Slovakia who've worked in New York and have spent time in conversation. Again, for me to receive this sort of comments, it's quite new to me, because throughout my life, the public, as I've said before, have never seen any of my artwork. Yes, I've had compliments off certain people who've come through my own, but really now the public's seen what is happening here, and it's very gratifying to think that already the interest is there. But anyway, another day is finished. I already know what I'm going to do tomorrow. I'm going to try and fill this area with what's already in my mind. And so again, I'm looking forward until tomorrow. And so with that, I'm going to say good night, and I wish you all well. Thank you.